Yagatti Reef is the name we've given to a massive area of reef out off the east coast of Queensland. This aerial view of Yagatti Reef shows the huge amount of fishing area available. And as of filming this DVD, we'd probably only explored about 20% of the entire reef structure. The easiest way to access Yagatti Reef is to fly out aboard a seaplane from Hamilton Island and meet our 80-foot mothership sitting in one of the calm, sheltered lagoon anchorages. The footage you're about to watch was all filmed in just one day's fishing aboard one of our 25-foot center consoles at Yagatti Reef.
Let's have a start over here and have a couple of casts just straight towards this edge here.
Yeah, as the current falls into it, you see sort of the edge I'm working to. As the current falls into the hole, they generally swim up and down that edge.
Right, we've been fishing some pressure points and sort of on the reef this morning, and we haven't seen many fish. So I've come a little bit further east out to sea, and we're fishing some underwater reef, some deep water shoals, comes up to about 10 meters. The fish have been over the past week eating better on the shoals, so we'll have a cast here and see. Right, go for it, guys. Awesome, good going, Dave, well done. Yeah, Dave was casting a little 80-gram dogtooth stick bait. Yeah, it looks like he's hooked up to a GT. On some luck, yeah. Awesome, good stuff. Looked like a decent-sized fish when he ate the lure. I'd say in his 20s, so... Just doing a nice big circle, he'll come around again. There he comes out. There he is. Oh, he's a good-sized fish. Right, just swing the leader to me and I'll grab it. Well done. Nice fish. Well done, Dave. Good stuff, Dave. Got him nice in the scissor there. That hook was never going to come out. You had him well and truly. Good stuff, Dave. Well done. You mean just let him go? That's it. Straight over. One good fish for the day, and we've hooked up a fish. Got him to the boat on nice light gear with a little, well, should lure, yeah, a little dog tooth 80-gram stick bait. They work really well in the blue hole sometimes. Coral trout, red bass, jobfish, emperors, and primarily GTs is what we're going into the holes for. But yeah, rightio. Oh, that fish actually went in the reef there. You can see how the leader's been touched up a little bit. Just come around the corner here and noticed a shoal of bait fish. Yeah, you guys carry on casting. Noticed a shoal of bait fish that's packed up in the corner very tightly there. It doesn't look like they're happy with life. Obviously something bigger is trying to eat them. Hopefully we get a bite here. Very surprised you never got a bite there. Such good bait fish. Would be things like shark, mackerel, and those sort of fish chasing them, I reckon. Oh, he's on it! Yeah, that's it. That's it, hooked up. God, Nick. Keep the pressure on him. He's still there.
I think a hook pulled. Oh, awesome take! Oh, keep the pressure, Brock. Pressure on him. Wind onto him. That's it. Yeah, keep the pressure. He's shaking his head. He's trying to get the hook out of his mouth. Still shaking. Still shaking.
Yeah.
There we go. Now he knows he's hooked. Good stuff. Well done, Brock. Awesome take. Leader. Right, I'll be there in a second. Decent sized fish.
Brock just got the fish on a popper, yeah, fishing on that bommy over there. There we go. Nice fish, well done, Brock.
Thanks.
Yeah, you can drop him over, it'll be good. Off he goes. Yeah, we're just hopping over some blue holes now to get to another good one that I fished. As we're entering it, you can see there's a bommy, Brock.
Yep.
I'm gonna try and go on the left of the bommy. I want you to cast it, or sort of, or all you guys need to land somewhere near that bommy. Yep. The fish just, it's like a little house for GTs, I reckon. Alright guys, let's have a cast over here. Water looks awesome here. Yeah. I think it's game time. There's a couple! One will eat it. There's a whole heap of them. On the left? Yeah, yeah, right there, just on the left of that bomb. Come on! Oh, keep the pressure on it, Brock! There's a whole pack of them! Get your lures in there, guys! There's heaps of them! This way, Jay, this way. Got him! Awesome! Well done, Brock! Get a bite now for sure. Keep the pressure on him, keep the pressure on him. Double hook up! Double hook up! There's a pack! Double hook up! Yes! Come to the front, come to the front. Dave, there's one on your lure, there's one on your lure! He's gonna eat it! Oh! Jesus, look at the size of that one! That one's 50, look at all of them! Oh god! Game on, guys! Alright! Sorry, there was a 50 kilo one swimming there. There we go, Dave! Keep casting, keep casting. There, there, there. Awesome. Did you see all of them swimming by the boat? There was a couple massive ones. Bro, there was two that huge ones that came up on Dave's stick bait. Oh, there's another one on it.
Eat it.
Man, the one that came up on Dave's stick bait was a truck. First the shark came, and he just came. Pretty mental. This is one of my favorite spots, I call it stables. See all the little channels, how they run in like that? Yeah. And just about in every channel, there's a pack of GTs like that. So it's never let me down to this day. We're just cruising along the shallows now. We just saw two GTs swim straight inside this hole over here, so hopefully they're still going to eat the lures. Oh! Man, that was a big fish, that one. That fish would have gone 30 kilos. Righto guys, as we drift into this channel here, as you see how the current's draining into it, as we drift in, we're going to have a cast there and fish it much like we'd fish a blue hole. All the fish now, what would have happened is the reef is getting too shallow for them, so the fish are starting to swim off the reef now and back into the main ocean. And then they'll feed around bommies and stuff like that. And then as soon as the tide comes back in, they'll come back up these sort of drains. And as soon as there's enough water to go back on the reef, they'll go back inside and go to feed in the blue holes again. Generally a lot of bait inside the blue holes for them to eat, so there's normally always fish inside them, especially when there's a lot of current. Bam! When you've finished acquiring your satellites, Brock, you can have a cast towards that bommy over there. Keep going. Got him! Awesome, well done. Don't be scared of drag on that fish, eh? Gonna drive him off that reef there. On top of the reef at the moment. Oh, he's right on top there. Come, my boy, come. Oh, he's just coming around that bommy. Okay, I think we're far enough away from the reef here. Well done, Brock. Solid hookup, hey, looked at it once and just came up and smashed it, eh? It's good stuff. Oh, he's angry.
Not happy.
Oh, he's on it, he's on it! There's a pack of them, there's a pack of them, guys. Keep popping your lure, Brock. There's on it, dude. They're on it, Brock. They're on it. Oh, no! Oh, massive coral trout! Oh, it's a big... What is that, a red... Oh, that was a coral trout, I think. Yeah. Double hookup. Awesome. Set those hooks properly, guys. Make sure he's on. Okay, I'm going to back him out. Brock, how's the lines there, bro? Yeah, no, I can see that. Jay, I think you're under. You're over, Jay. You're over, Jay. Run over. You're over. Yeah, you're over. Keep the pressure on him. That's it. Yeah, just keep the pressure on him. Good stuff, guys. Brock, you might want to come to the back, eh? It's passing rod. I'll take it down for you. Yeah. You got it, eh?
Cool.
Keep casting off the front there, Dave. Maybe get a triple. Well done, guys. Awesome. Yeah, we had to stop and fish along this ledge here. See how the current's actually pushing over there. And obviously a pack of fish sitting here. Had about 5 or 6 fish up. And managed to get a double hookup out of it. So, good stuff.
Oh, look at that.
Oh. Check there. Little one.
But,
GT nevertheless.
Let's have a look here.
That GT actually swallowed the bait and the hook got stuck on something in its stomach.
That's a fusilier that was stuck in the GT's stomach. That's yeah.
He was hungry, that oak.
Yeah, that's a bit of a better one.
Nice. That's it.
It just started drifting over the ledge here.
Oh, this GT's trying to eat it.
It's a little mackerel.
Little shark mackerel, Dave. Little shark mackerel they've just caught.
On that little stick bait again. GT's up his back though.
Whoa! He's on it.
That's a good boy.
Yep.
Not for 3 weeks at a time, man. Still got another week and a half, it's got time to heal.
Fuck, I haven't caught one of these. Not a bad one. He's a better one. Nice GT. Awesome.
Good day. Weather's awesome out here today. Inside there, there's a nice pressure point over there. See on that bommy and this bommy here, in between there's a little sort of shoal there. A whole lot of baits along that edge there if you want to have a throw there. See what comes up.
Whoa. Love your work, Jay.
Hey, fill
him up, should have put him away from the reef for you, Jay. Get ready to get some slack line. I'm just going to idle back on it. Take him around if you can, or do you want me to drive on him? There we go. Yeah, Jay's been fishing with a stick bait most of the day. He just changed onto a popper. First throw, bang, got him, sir. Missed a couple fish with a stick bait, had some lookers. First decent one that you've hooked up for the day, I'd say. Yeah, you might probably go 30, that oak.
You're up on 7.
Battling there, mate.
Whoa, it's a good one.
Swim on top of the rod.
Goes. Awesome. Well done, buddy. You got him.
Assistance pays off.
We've done pretty well today. What's it now?
2 o'clock, and that's 10 fish for the day. So it's been good. Well done, guys. Let's go catch some more. Okay, we're gonna fish off the right hand side of the boat. Right, I've stopped on another point, Joe. We've got awesome current flowing around it. Good bait shoal sitting on the side, a bunch of fusiliers, so I'm pretty sure there'll be a fish here. We'll have a go.
Oh.
Got him! That's it.
It's awesome, mate.
Good stuff, man. Hey, look, those look like two quality fish that came up there. Yeah, no, that's a good fish you got. Well done, man. See how he came and looked at it first, and his mate came, bam, inside paddled him. That was awesome. Oh, hello, hello. Ooh. Nearly went for a swim, old Jay.
That magic carp in the green,
though. It's quite a cheeky one, this. He's all over the place, eh? Yeah, actually not foul. He's angry. Now, if you could dance like this on a dance floor, you'd hook up with plenty of stock. Eh? Got all the moves happening, eh? You can see they've got a fair amount of drag on there. And it's pulling him around quite a bit, so yeah, I'm expecting quite a big fish to come out. Just some colour there.
Oh yeah, he's a goodie. Nice fat one, eh? He's a goodie.
Oh yeah, he'll go over 30. Whew, well done, mate. That's a big fish.
112 centimetres.
107 and 89. Big fish, he'll probably be about 28 kilos, I'd say. Back she goes, well done, mate.
Got some good picks.
Nice picks there.
Keep going, keep reeling. That's it, mate, good job. Coming up top, on top of the ledge.
That's it, you're doing a good job, Dave. Keep it up.
Thank you.
awesome take.
Go up to the front if you want, Brock. Yeah. There, see the bait there? A little bit forward. Just sort of
a little bit right to the sun.
See how many goes he had.
He had about four or five takes before this one got stuck. Good.
Got it, yep.
Get into him, get into him!
That's it.
Oh, there's one on it, Dave! There's one on it! Double hookup, Dave! Woohoo! Gotta go the triple, guys! Go the triple, Brock!
And I'll go past the
friend. Sounds like a good idea. Don't know how you missed that one, Dave. Seven for the day for yourself. That's awesome going. It's number 15 for the boat today.
Oh, that's why he went so hard. You got him in his last black one.
Last GT for the afternoon. There he goes. Righto, that's awesome. Let's go catch a couple more. We've probably got about 20 minutes left. And yeah, good water, so yeah, carry on using it.
Right, you ready, guys?
Hey, awesome, Brock, well done, mate. That was pretty cool, eh?
Yeah,
he's
playing.
Just like does not play games.
You mean business, bro?
Oh, he's on it, Brock! Oh, he's on it! Yes. Got him, Jay! Got him, Brock! Double hookup! Oh, no! This place is going off! Every course!
When we finish up with a triple hookup, guys, we can go home. Yeah, I think we've got a decent sized fish here. We stopped on another the same shoal we've been catching all the fish on. And yeah, we pulled up after catching, I think we've caught 7 or 8 fish along the shoal. Pulled up here and stopped in a new place. Straight away we had a double hookup. One of the fish fell off. We've got this fish left, so yeah, pretty stoked. All good.
There we go. It's another good GT for the day. All nice, very fat, healthy fish.
Nice spaghetti reef specimen.
Back she goes.
Get into him. Don't be scared of him.
Oh, got him.
Oh, got him.
Give him on. Give him stick. Give him stick.
Oh, no, he's there. Give him stick. More.
It's another one.
Keep it. How ridiculous is the fishing at the moment, guys?
It's just every single time we pull up to the shoal, there's a fish there, guaranteed. This is the 10th fish we've hooked on the shoal now. Been fishing here since, what, 2:30? And the time now, it's 4 o'clock and
yeah,
we've got 10 fish out and we've lost double, or we've lost probably 10 as well. So,
pretty amazing fishing.
Yeah. Get one right up the reef that way, Brock, on your next course. Yeah, you see those little ripples up towards there.
That head hook seems to be getting a bit of a better hookup, right?
Yep, number 19 for the day.
Yeah, we lost quite a bit of fish earlier in the day and kind of changed our hook method. And we're using one assist hook off the head now, off the head of the popper,
and a tail hook off the back.
And I'd say out of the last 5 fish, we've caught 4 of them on the top hook, so yeah, definitely helped us a bit. Fish are all very, very fat and healthy today. Not very big, it's about another 20 kilo model, but really fat fish.
Awesome, back she goes.
Oh, on! Yeah, hooked up, awesome. Oh no, man.
Yeah, Tim, could you just tell Carl I might be a little late this afternoon? I'm pretty far south and we got into a couple of fish this afternoon, so yeah.
Yeah, it'll be about a half an hour run.
Thank you for that. Yeah, nice one, close by. That's Brock hooked into his number 7 for the day.
Might be around, mate.
The soaker's like a... Should call you Samson, mate. You're too strong, bro. There we go. That's another fish. Brock just got number 20 for the afternoon. Awesome. 20 fish in a day. You can't beat that. There's not many places in the world I'd dream of catching that many GTs in a day. So
back she goes.
Awesome.
Well done, mate.
Woohoo! It's all happening. Oh yeah, we have to leave, as much as I don't want to leave this place, but
we're gonna get in trouble otherwise.
We're already a little bit late, so yeah, looking forward to come back here tomorrow and catch a couple more fish. Awesome, right guys, let's head.
Thanks, Lenny.
Not a problem.
Awesome! Wow. That's good stuff, man. That's yeah, check that one.
There we go! Another one in the boat!
Wow!
Awesome!
Yes.
12 feet.
Here's number...
That's number 23, guys!
Awesome, back she goes.
And we've got Dave busy with a 50 pound gear with number 24.
Good going, well done, guys.
Well done, Jack.
Well done, Johnny. That's the end of the day, guys. Good stuff.
And a triple hookup.
Triple hookup, 50 pound. To beat the record.
Good fish, well done, Dave.
Well done, Dave, that's your fish.
Well done, Dave.
24 fish for the day, guys, and we just ended it off with a triple hookup. I suppose it's about time to go home and drink some beer. What do you guys think?